This is what is left of Nakabu Primary School in Luka District. Most of the pupils are attending classes under trees without desks, and some sit directly on the ground. There is also no toilet. This is the aftermath of a storm that shattered the school's main building. The structure was accommodating 7 classrooms. Despite the dangerous state of the remaining 3 classrooms, teaching goes on.
With each other, and they're not comfortable when they sit like that. That sitting posture is not good, because each desk is meant for 3 children. But now they are 5, 6. So that makes them not be comfortable in class. And so the class hour may not be all that effective to their...
Not exercise their activities when they are seated together like that. And when it comes to writing, they have no space where they put the books to write. Others sit in their friends' books. Then others go on piercing their friends with their pencils when struggling to write. They do not concentrate highly.
Teachers, parents and pupils are appealing to the government to renovate the school whose roofs are caving in and cracks tearing through the dilapidated structures. The head teacher of the school, Juma Balikudembe, details that they currently have a total of 1,242 pupils and the pressure was already being felt even before the storm.
The building was built a long time in 1952. As we talk now, it is out of use, reason being that it got collapsed due to the heavy rains that happened in 2020 off the roof of this building. Since then, we decided to remove the children from this building and they are now studying under trees. 3 classes, that is P2, P3 and P4, they are under trees just because of the condition of the building.
The building was constructed in 1952. Sympathizers are welcome to help in restoring the school.
This building collapsed. I happened to have approached the office of the Prime Minister through the Minister of Education and Sports. And when we went there, we promised to be helped in terms of building the building, or rather the classrooms. And that, according to their pledge, it was supposed to be 9 classes for the school. But when COVID came in, so happens that program was left out.
About 4 complete classrooms in this school, even more because the enrollment is big. So we are appealing the head teacher, the school management committee, to sit together. They will invite us. We start writing proposals. There are always people who are able to get it.
As pupils and teachers grapple with the dire learning conditions, the district education office says it is financially constrained.
To us, the office of the Prime Minister visited them. We agreed. Writings went to Kampala and they came for an assessment. We are waiting for the response from the office of the Prime Minister. I know is that as Luka Education Department, we receive money which can only and only put up 2 schools.
That were affected during the pandemic. Some of the schools, the roofs were blown off. Some of the latrines collapsed during that time, and really those schools are in sorry state. The leaders of those schools, let us hold meetings with the parents, PTA and management, and resolve on the way forward.
Their hope now is that the central government intervenes. Report by Ivan Wachibi for the news.